are technically 5 miles east of Washington, D.C., and that's where you find this place, FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. It's all about divisional matchups on this final day of the regular season, and we've got a compelling one in store here, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Washington Commanders. Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet Leather. And we are underway from FedEx Field. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And a less than desirable return as he's out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
Jimmy going to look to throw it on the first play. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And that's out to the flat for Swift. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it's second down.
Here we go.
Brings up second and 4.
11.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And this is going to be a Commander's first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
There's Garoppolo on first and 10. Complete, it's Johnson. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
But that last throw, Charles, puts him over 15,000 yards passing now for his career.
And Brandon, they're not going to stop the game and give him the game ball here, but that's still a pretty impressive number. And he's got plenty of more good football ahead of him. Although I would say the team should give him a game ball after it's all over.
So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. As the season winds down and you look at them in totality, you know, the offense has struggled. The defense has been pretty good, so I would imagine the changes this offseason may be more on the offensive side of the ball.
And this is where we always hear the term complementary football, because as you noted, the defense has played well enough for them to win games, and the offense has helped them back. So they've got to reward that defense by improving on offense. If you make a change of quarterback, running back, tight end, it doesn't matter. Get better players, better system, so they can play to the standards of the defense, and the win column will result.
They'll come up facing third and 5.
11. 11.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. He'll get this off to Swift. And he's going to have a Commanders first down. He needed five. He got it barely as it would officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, here's Swift. And he fights forward for a modest 2 yard gain, second down. You look at this Cowboy defense. Against the pass, they're toward the middle of the league, number 15 in the NFL.
So I'm prepping for this game. I kept asking myself the question, what's keeping this group from being top 10 in the league against the pass?
And
too many mistakes, especially little mistakes. And those add up into big mistakes. Big mistakes add up into points against you.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10.
21.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Throw left side, and Osborne has it. This defense for the Cowboys, they were terrific a week ago in that win over Detroit.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Brandon, watching their tape from last week, I saw plenty of plays like we just saw there, forcing incompletions. It was key in their win last week. They're hoping the same thing happens this time out, too.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on third. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 31-yard line. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12.
At the Cowboys' 33-yard line.
Garoppolo going to change the look here. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Right back to Swift again on second down. And not much running room. Down to the 32. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play. Stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 18. They give him 14 yards that time, and a fresh set of downs. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. The sack there by Rasheem Green. Not the start to this one that any quarterback would want or envision. Remember, he had the pick six, and here he is. Second quarter now from our nation's capital, and it's Washington in possession of the football as they've got it with a second and 13 forthcoming.
Here we go. 21.
Now they'll audible to something else. Garoppolo out wide here with Samuel. And this will be a gain of six when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21. And this offense on third down today, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 7. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. Samson Ebukam able to get him down for a loss of 11. And it brings up fourth down. Butker's kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal you'll take,
punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing now is Allen. That's caught. It's Marvin Mims. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long. Had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
They'll run on first down with Evans. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Now, these two teams, you might remember, met earlier in the year in Arlington with the Cowboys winning that ball game. So they're looking for another win here in Washington to take the season sweep.
Second and 10. Allen now looks to throw. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And the Commanders are going to take possession here at their own 33.
Allen's pass intercepted.
Here we go.
The Commanders take over first and 10 at their own 33.
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down.
21. Here we go.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Over the middle, complete. It's Osborne. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
65.
That's good for our Commanders.
13.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. On the right side, open is Gesicki. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To throw is Garoppolo. That's complete. Once again, it's Gesicki. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
I don't care what sport you're playing. Everyone likes to build up a little momentum, don't they? And look at this, back-to-back completions to the big target at tight end.
That one not as profitable as the other, but still a decent game. On second down, Swift. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage.
21.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Cowboys are going to take over at their own 13-yard line. So consecutive interceptions here early on in this one, and maybe setting the tone, Charles, for a game where the defense really takes center stage.
And don't you think that both offenses are really catching a bit from their coaching staff about avoiding these turnovers that we've seen early? I think both teams are trying to find an advantage. We know that. Can one of them break away and take control of this game?
It'll be a gain of 5, and that will bring up second down.
Yard
Evans running behind center. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Throwing on first down is Allen. Wilson's got it on the crossing route.
I know we just saw a nice throw and catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Second down and 4. To the air, Allen. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Allen now on first down. His throw here is incomplete.
Offense is moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earn a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Now a second and 10. Here's Allen. This is caught by Evans. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Yeah, big play there. When you have a running back that you can use like a wide receiver, when he has that kind of versatility, you do as they did there. Get him out of the backfield and give those defensive backs something else to worry about.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Allen. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Oh, that's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up, converged on his man, and broke the play up.
Here's second and 10. Option play they give to Evans. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Here's Allen to throw it. Touchdown, Cowboys! Darrington Evans, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Cowboys will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a 2-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line.
out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. He'll get three of those penalty yards back here, leaving him with a second and 12.
Brings up second and 12.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Ready for the second half. 14-3 our score as we are back underway on EA Sports. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 33-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going. So they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's second and three. On the counter, it's Evans. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Heavy set out there on third and one. They'll try and run for this with Evans. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. This defense not budging. Back-to-back carries of just 2 yards. Now here's Michael Dixon. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And, Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
18 yards the gain for number 18. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. On first and 10, it's Swift. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Dexter Lawrence finding his way through defensively for the stop. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss.
12, fellas, here we go. I got this. 21.
Garoppolo. And his throw is incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked him from the moment it left the quarterback's hand. And that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
11.
Garoppolo now. Quick completion here to Johnson. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. Washington going to send out their punter as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave them with a second and just a few inches left. Evans running straight ahead. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Allen. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here. Over 20 yards. Play action. Now it's Allen. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. Garrett Wilson, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. From midfield, here's Allen. All the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. Trey Hendrickson able to use that strength to get him for a loss of two.
Like how they started the third quarter here, they forced a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely, maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. Third and 12. To throw, it's Allen. Knocked away and incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Commanders will take over, but backed up deep in their own territory.
Here we go.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points. And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big play.
Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Look at the big man Rummel. Inside the 10, touchdown, Washington. Mike Gesicki, 88 yards. And the Commanders have got it back to within a score. Now Garoppolo will lead his guys up to go for the two-point try.
Hey,
now they'll change things up. Now receiver in motion left. They'll try to run with Swift. And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark knock him inside the one. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches, and the two-point attempt is turned aside. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
56, 56.
On play action, Allen. This one finds Wilson downfield. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think that's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run. From the 25, here's second down at 7.
Alert.
Now Allen. He'll flip this out to Evans. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself, because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs. And they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Evans gets it again on second down. And stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
The offense on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Going to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a one-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And remember, despite giving up the field goal, this is still a one-score game. They're in need of a touchdown and a two-point conversion. A field goal on this drive likely doesn't do them much good. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. A
again. It's Johnson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. There's Garoppolo to throw. And that's out to the flat for Swift. That's good for a gain of six, and it'll be second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Garoppolo's throw complete there to Johnson. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And that's a much needed first down right there. Look, they're down by eight. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now.
Swift going to try up the middle. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. To throw, it's Garoppolo. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 21. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. On first down, Garoppolo.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
From the 21, it's second and 10.
21, 21. White.
On play action, now Garoppolo. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Some coaches like to take the shorter, more reliable yardage, and some, they like to go for the big shot. No fear of risking a deep ball there, but wasn't enough to get them the completion.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Garoppolo again. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. A 38-yard attempt. Butker's kick here is good, and that'll get the lead down to five. So an interesting call there to take the three, and I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf, dude. That's bottom shelf material. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's a handoff to Evans out of the gun. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to have
this across midfield and inside the 45.
As he'll run on first down.
And he's going to be met at about the 43.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Another run on second down, trying to cover up.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
First down line at the 34 here on third down.
They'll stay on the ground. Evans again.
And he got blown out. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44.
They had three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good, and they'll be unable to build here onto their five-point lead.
Now, partner, it's almost a little jarring to see a holder set up on the other side of midfield. I haven't brought out my binoculars to make sure on that one. That is showing an awful lot of confidence in a kicker to try and hit from 61 yards, and this one winds up no good.
Here we go.
This is first and 10.
65, 65. 13, 13.
To throw, Garoppolo. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
A little less than 40 seconds remaining. Here comes second and 10.
To throw is Garoppolo. That's caught by Johnson. And he's corralled, but now before getting it inside the 35.
Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts
as they'll stop him with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
Two timeouts still available in this final
21,
minute.
21.
It's first and 10 now.
21, 21. Go ahead.
Garoppolo to throw. And he rips that one incomplete there.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into two-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand.
Here we go, here we go.
Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
12, here we go. 21,
21.
Get
on. Now Garoppolo. And he's got his tight end. It's Mike Gesicki.
And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout. Garoppolo is going to change the play.
Garoppolo out wide here with Samuel. He takes it across for the touchdown. And they've taken the lead late.
Standing drive right there to take the lead, and also, Charles, didn't leave the opposition with a whole lot of time on the clock.
Yeah, I like the way that you're viewing this because they did a tremendous job to put themselves in a position to win, but they can't celebrate just yet. They've got to clamp down on any big plays and force them to use up those timeouts without making any headway.
Extra point by Butker is on target.
And it would appear, barring some late heroics, they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. They'll come up first and 10 here. Allen. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it, and the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Charles, we retreated to an excellent game day, capped off by that second half comeback. This was a joy to watch.
Entertaining for us.